Hello everyone. Today we will learn about division of a sentence. How many parts are there in a sentence? And what are they? So, we speak, read or write sentences. But do you know that every sentence consists of two parts? And what are those two parts? Well, the two parts are subject and predicate. Now, children, what is a subject? Well, the person or thing we speak about is called the subject. The subject is the doer of the action. Well, in order to understand it better, you can ask a question to yourself. Your question should start with who or what. Now, coming to the predicate, what do you mean by the predicate? What is said about the subject is called the predicate. There is always a verb in the predicate. The predicate gives us information about what the subject of the sentence is or is doing. Now let us try to understand this with the help of an example. Let us take the example of this sentence. David takes tea. Don't forget to put a full stop. David takes tea. Now in this sentence, which part of it is the subject and which part is the predicate? So the easiest way is, as I said earlier, you have to ask question with who or what. So if you ask question with who, your question will be who takes tea? The answer is David. Therefore, David is your subject. S for subject. Rest of the part, whatever David is doing, is your predicate. Now remember, children, the predicate always carries a verb. There is always a verb in the predicate, and here your verb is takes. Let me remind you that verb means doing word or action word. Now let us look at another example. Milk is sweet. Milk is sweet. Now here again, you have to ask question. About what are we talking? Look here, children, we have to ask question either with who or what. Okay, so about what are we talking in this sentence? We are talking about milk. Therefore, milk is your subject here. It is the subject of the sentence. And rest of the part is the predicate. Is sweet is the predicate. Now you must be wondering that I said there will be a verb in the predicate. Now where is verb here? Well, in this case, is the verb. Okay, it is the be verb. So dear children, I hope that now you can easily identify subject and predicate. So children, your homework will be to do exercise M, page number 17 in your book. You have to match the subject to the correct predicate. See you in the next class. Till then, all of you take care. Bye-bye.